How does this have flow? Oh, jump, oh, no, what the, oh, 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 there, kill us.
Oh, well, that's something new. I think I should be more careful with this. Hello everyone, Simon Bard here, and please welcome back for some more of Sulli-Ween. Yep, Sulli-Ween has returned, and I figured that I'd start it off by reviewing a movie based on a series of books. And with its sequel coming out this Friday, there is no better time to do it. So, let's look at the fun yet awkward and silly adaptation of Goosebumps. The movie is based on the books published by Scholastic Inc. and written by R.L. Stine, who also makes a cameo in the film as Hallway Player, or known in the film as Mr. Black. You'll see what I mean. A teenage boy named Zach Cooper moves into Madison, Georgia with his mother, Gail, as she has a job working as vice principal for the high school Zach goes to. But Zach soon meets a teenage girl named Hannah, who lives next door to him, and the two get along well despite her father keeping the two separate and telling Zach to leave his daughter alone or bad things will happen. Thinking the neighbor dad is a psychopath to his daughter, Zach and his new friend Champ go inside the house to see if she's fine, and notices a shelf of Goosebumps manuscripts. But upon opening one book, it unleashes the monster inside and causes havoc. Soon the two boys find out that Hannah's father is R.L. Stine, and even after capturing the monster back in the book, a living ventriloquist dummy named Slappy comes out of one of the books and burns it, and soon lets out all the other monsters from their books and burns them too. And as the town's being terrorized by every Goosebumps monster, Zach, Champ, Hannah, and Stine have to find out how to rid all these monsters before they cause more havoc. Now, I never read any of the Goosebumps books, but I do love the covers they showed, and I did watch the Goosebumps TV show, which has a fun main theme, but I forgot about some of the episodes I saw, and I didn't see every single one of them. But what this movie presented to me was good enough for knowing some things about the material.
And even if I never read the books, there are still plenty of good things happening throughout the film. All the monsters being shown do look pretty good, many of them either CGI or in costumes, and they do come from the books they're featured in, with designs varying from the cover, but they're good enough. And also taken from the non-original series. But I would have loved to see more Goosebumps monsters, like with the Haunted Mask and Monster Blood. But what can you do? Even the G in Goosebumps is slightly different, but it still feels the same. Though I would like to know why an animation company is co-producing a live-action film. I guess it's the effects portion of it, but I think there's more to it than that. The actor playing Stine is pretty good, giving quite a funny take on it, and made me wonder how the real Stine felt about this, even with the dialogue he says. However, what keeps me from enjoying this film is the tone it has. It is silly, but it's also awkward and unnatural, namely the humor it has. They don't get much of a laugh or a chuckle from me, and it's pretty odd either way. Even the acting from some of the adults felt off.
But the actors playing their characters did a fine job as is.
Jack Black plays R.L. Stine and voices Slappy and the Invisible Boy. Dylan Minnette plays Zach Cooper. Odia Rush plays Hannah. Ryan Lee plays Champ, short for Champion. Amy Ryan plays Gail Cooper. Jillian Bell plays Lorraine Cooper. Halston Sage plays Taylor. Steven Kruger plays Davidson. Keith Arthur Brown plays Principal Garrison. Amanda Lund plays Officer Brooks. Timothy Simmons plays Officer Stevens. Ken Marino plays Coach Carr. And Caleb Emery plays Dumb Jock. Yeah, I know he has a name in the film, but I forgot what it was, so I'm going by the IMDb credit. As a whole, this movie is fun, yet silly. The characters are good for what they are, the story is nice as is, and the effects are pretty good. Director Rob Letterman had done a serviceable job of bringing the Goosebumps books and monsters to life, literally, and in a story that felt like a mixture of Hocus Pocus and Jumanji. But his humor is somewhat awkward and kind of unnatural, and has more of a silly tone and style. And I could have wished for more of the book's feel, despite not reading any of them. Yet with the plenty of twists and turns, Jack Black as Stine, the author himself making a quick cameo, the effects, and Danny Elfman's music, it's all kind of good fun despite the silliness it has, and hopefully the sequel would be just as good or better.
So today, this movie would get a rating of 2.5+ stars. So thank you for joining me. Like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook or Twitter, support me on Patreon, And tune in next time for more of Sulli-Ween.